Sean Zatella, theboxingvoice.com, here with Jesse Vargas, former two-division champion. Beautiful win tonight. You won every second of every round, knocked him down in the sixth. So what grade do you give yourself in your first fight back?
I'm my own worst critic. So for that reason, I would give myself a C. You know, there's things to improve upon. Besides that, I mean, a 13-month layoff doesn't come easy. You know, it's my first time being off that long. And I did feel the ring rust, but it's a part of the game. I'm glad to be back, and that's the most important thing. I'm back. I'm with Premier Boxing Champions. And guess what? The welterweight division is stacked, and we're all within the Premier Boxing Champions stable. And I'm looking forward to giving the fans excitement in this next 2018-2019. You know, the welterweight division is stacked, and I want to conquer the WBC-WBA title, you know, and show that I'm the best. But I'm en route in the right direction, actually.
How did you feel mentally in this fight? Because you're a young man who's already made a good amount of money. You've got commentating with HBO Latino, so there's questions from me if you would still be just as hungry as you always were. So how did you feel mentally tonight?
Better than ever. You know why? Besides the ring rust, of course. But I felt very calm. I felt very relaxed. I knew what was going on. I knew what I was doing. I knew his timing. I knew whenever he had his desire of coming in and putting the pressure on. So I'm a more experienced fighter. I said it before, this is the second stage of my career, and it's different. It's always better because you being more experienced, you're more relaxed. You know what's going on. There's no surprises. You know, in this fight, I was able to stay relaxed, stay composed, just basically use him as target practice, just the jab, the right hand. And this is a guy, keep in mind, that is used to just coming forward. He's an all-out brawler. You know, he comes in, he has the Mexican style, but in this fight, he thought twice about coming in. He was very hesitant. He was using his head moving a lot, like knowing that there was something to watch out for, and that was my power. You know, he's fighting with several fighters, and I guess that this fight, you know, he had a lot of respect for me.
When you dropped him in the sixth, was that something you planned? Because it looked like you turned it up a little bit in that round. So was that by design, or did the knockdown just come?
The knockdown just came. I mean, it seemed that he wanted to put pressure, and I said, okay, let's do it. And then that's when I got him, pop, 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 and he went down on the third shot. And it was just a well-executed shot, a shot that actually Mike McClellan was asking me for. And I put it down, and it was very successful. We took him down. I should have capitalized, but once again, you know, it comes 13 months off, and we look forward to perfecting that the next time around.
You brought up the jab. Everything tonight was off the jab. Is that the best? Is that your best punch?
I like it. I like the way it sounds. I like the way it makes their head snap back. I like the way it opens up other shots. When I took him down, it was a hook that started it, but he thought the jab was coming. I just saw it coming. I mean, I was basically landing any shot that I wanted, you know, whether it was the jab, and then everything was off the jab, and it was the hook and the right hand. But once again, you know, I give myself a C, and I look forward to giving my fans a better performance in the next fight. You know, 13 months off did make a change, did make a difference.
You've always had a good jab. It was good tonight. Why do you think other fighters don't use the jab? We're always hearing trainers say, you know, pop the jab, use the jab. Why do you use it more than other fighters? Why don't other fighters, we don't see it as much?
It's not that easy. It's not that easy using the jab because you can get countered from the jab as well. You can get countered from the jab, and sometimes the other guy might have another jab. Maybe you can get hit with the same jab on the opposite side, you know, as you're jabbing. But with me, you can't jab a jabber. You can't jab me, you know, no matter what. And I've always known that. And, you know, that's why I shoot everything off the jab because I could just – I don't have to put power on my jab at all times. I could just put it out there to set something else up. I could put power on my jab, and it hurts just as much as a right hand. And that's probably why.
Do you think, in your opinion, should the title fight be next, or should you get one more fight in before taking on a guy with a title in the division?
That's all up to my advisor.
What if it was up to you? What do you think?
If it was up to me, I'd fight next for a world title. I'd ask for a world title next, but, you know, I got to sit back, talk to my advisor, and see what's next. Guadalupe Valencia O'Heyman, I'm happy to be working with them, and I'm looking forward to the next fight as soon as possible.
Now, out of all those guys, though, you know, there's now Horn's got a belt again, or he has a belt. Thurman and Spence.
Horn, I jab him to death. I mean, he's fighting with Crawford. Best of luck to my boy Crawford. And welcome to the welterweight division, and you know, I wish him all the best. And we will. I'm sure we're in the same division, and we're gonna see a lot of each other.
Now, I heard you say earlier that you want the guy with the WBC and the WBA. So does that mean Thurman over anybody else?
If you ask me, I want Thurman. I want Thurman. I want the WBC and I want the WBA belt. Those are the two belts that I want to have.
You know, I got to ask you this before I let you go. Saddam Ali, you knocked him out when you fought a year and a half ago. Since then, he beat a legend in Miguel Cotto, won a junior middleweight title. Is that rematch? Would you want to rematch him to win a title, to potentially win a belt at junior middleweight?
You know, the rematch is up to him. You know, he's the one that lost the first fight. He got knocked out in 9 rounds. And if he wants to fight again, we'll do it.
All right. Thanks, Jesse.
All right, no problem.
All right. The game, cause see the boxing boys.